Robert Plank Show, Episode 17, How to Make Money Using Facebook, Traffic, Ads, and Fan Pages. Hello everyone and welcome back to the Robert Plank Show. It's great to have you, whether you're a first time or a long time listener. We are going to get your problem solved, we're going to get your business built up, and we're going to get you making more money starting today and on for the rest of your life. So, when it comes to you marketing online, why is it that a heck of a lot of people are doing better off than you? Why is it that they're all basically eating your lunch, doing a better job marketing? And I'll give the answer right now. The answer is traffic, okay? Other people have more traffic than you do, and if you can get more traffic, then that means that you'll get more sales. Now, whether for you, sales means more people coming into your store, more people buying your coaching, more people buying your Kindle book, or your digital book, or your home study course, or your membership site, whatever it is, you need to have more traffic. And to be honest, I went for several years without realizing that that was my problem. I would spend about 80% of my time creating information products, creating training, creating content, things to sell, and only about 20% of my time getting people to see what it is I had created. And the reason why I jumped from making under $10,000 a month to well over $10,000 a month, that transition happened because I switched it around. I spent about 20% of my time figuring out what kind of content, what kind of things I was going to sell, and then 80% of my time selling it. 80% of the time getting joint ventures, telling affiliates to promote me, setting up free traffic coming in, and most importantly, getting that paid traffic. So if your competitors, for example, if they, let's say that, you know, in the past they've got maybe 1,000 to 2,000 visitors to their sites per day. Maybe they put out articles, blog posts, podcasts like this one. They had an affiliate program going, and then they went out onto Google AdWords, they went onto Facebook, they did retargeting campaigns, and they paid for people to come to their site, and it all totaled up to 1,000 or 2,000 visitors every single day. And then they converted them into what's called a squeeze page or an opt-in page. So let's say that they got, just to make the math simple, 1,000 opt-ins per day, which is, if you're doing that, you're doing fantastic in your business. And these are all 1,000 people who are super targeted. So if it's like a local chiropractor, these are all people in the area who are interested in possibly getting an appointment with a chiropractor. If it is, if your niche is like getting in shape, well, then maybe you had 1,000 people a day who were interested in getting your supplement or your workout plan or your diet plan or some other kind, whatever your product or your solution is. So 1,000 opt-ins a day. Let's see that for that went on for 100 days. 100 days of paying for these ads, getting people to promote, and then so you had a list of 100,000 subscribers, right? Well, now when it comes to time to promote something, to sell something, you can expect about 2% of your list, if it's well-maintained, 2% of the entire list to click on a link in your email. So if you send out an email out of 100,000, what does that come out to? That comes out to about 2,000 people clicking over. Right? And if you did that for 10 days, when I had 20,000 clicks to your site, and let's say that once again, your site that you're sending people to, let's say that's a $100 product, and it converts at 2% on its own, right? So then doing the math once again, that means that you would have about 400 sales at 100 bucks. That's about $40,000. And so whether the numbers that you're dealing with are larger or smaller than that, you need to be thinking in those kinds of terms is how many leads are coming in per day, what size is my list, and then based on that, now I have somewhat of an idea of when I'm doing a promotion, I'm doing a week-long product launch, how many eyeballs can I expect to land on that sales letter and buy whatever that offer is, and then now I know where the problem is. Now, if I don't get those kinds of numbers, maybe it means that I need to train my list to click, maybe I need to send better emails, and we need to make the sales letter convert better, but either way, you're dead in the water unless you are building a list, unless you have traffic. So that's what we're talking about today is Facebook traffic. And I'm kind of a little bit nervous because a lot of the topics we've talked about in previous episodes of the Robert Plank Show have dealt with kind of evergreen topics, right? So the way that sales letters were written or articles were written 5, 10 years ago, I think are the same way they'll be written 5 or 10 years from now. So whether you're listening to this podcast in the year 2015 or 2027, whatever it is, I hope that the things we're talking about today as far as Facebook are somewhat similar. Now, the time that we're recording this, Facebook has over 1 billion users, 1 billion members, and they all are on the site at least once a day. They're on the site on their phones, they're at work and there's a tab open, they're on the site constantly. And so at the time we're recording this is the best and the fastest way for you to build a list and get sales. And at first I kind of laughed at all this social media stuff because people were talking about making money off Twitter. And what's Twitter? Well, for many years, just a way to, you'd add everyone else as a friend. They'd all add you as a friend. So you'd add 20,000 friends or 20,000 followers. Then they would follow you back. And hopefully, within that big sea of noise, someone would click and make money. It worked for a little trickle of traffic, but not a lot. I mean, I know people who, even affiliates, who said, oh yeah, I'm your traffic person. I have this huge Twitter list. They send out one tweet and they send about 30 clicks. And if you do the math from that 2%, I think we might have got one sale, if that, but it just wasn't that flood of thousands and thousands of people that we need in order for us to have enough money for it to be worthwhile. And then, you know, even when MySpace was popular, people said, oh, you know what I do is I join all these MySpace groups. I join the group on knitting, the group on clarinets, the group on tubas, and then send them my offer. And I'm thinking, well, if people are there just to interact and just to hang out, and it's mostly young people, then why are they going to want to buy your course on how to write articles? It just doesn't make sense. But now it makes sense, because people of all ages are on Facebook. A lot of people are on Facebook to do business and to network, and everyone's on. So this is the most high traffic site, except for Google, for you to make money on. And so let's talk about Google real quick, because I mean, Google is a great place for traffic, but it's kind of fickle, isn't it? So you could get free traffic. You could put out a bunch of articles. You could put out hundreds of articles onto article directories with a link back to your site. You could blog every day. You could, you know, keep cranking out all this content. You could, you know, get link backs and things like that. And that's great, except for it's slow and you can't depend on it. And you might build up and build up and build up, and then you get Google slapped. So then you think, okay, well, you know what? I'll put a few things out there just to get some free traffic. But while I'm waiting for that to pick up, I'm going to go for paid traffic. I'm going to pay for ads. I'm going to pay for some Google AdWords ads. And well, first of all, if you're in certain niches, and I mean niches even like internet marketing or make money online, then they will delete your account. I was selling a pop-up plugin for WordPress. Pops up a thing and asks for someone's name and email address. And just because I advertised that, Google closed my AdWords account because I said things like, well, if you can put this pop-up on your page, you can quadruple your signups, which I was able to verify. And then that means you've quadrupled your money because you convert more people coming to your site. And they said, well, you're promoting make money online. I'm like, it's a WordPress plugin, but still they said you're out. And I mean, you have to play by their rules. And the thing about Google that no one notices is that they hate customer support. It's almost impossible to talk to a real person in Google. You send them an email, about a few hours later, a fake reply comes back that pretends to be a person, but you cannot appeal any of their decisions, right? So Google, still, we have to deal with them because they're a huge site. They do send us lots of traffic, but you might get Google slapped, you might get deleted. And so even if you get lucky and you can advertise on AdWords, the problem with AdWords is that you're dealing with drive-by traffic, right? You make an ad saying, buy my golf training course, buy my real estate flipping course, and you target people who maybe search the word real estate. Well, problems with that. First of all, very competitive. And if someone is typing in the term real estate, we don't know if they're looking to buy a real estate course, if they're researching their competition, if they're looking into just figuring it out themselves, looking at real estate prices in their area. You're guessing. And then you can do these things like have long tail keywords, like bid on things like real estate course, real estate training. But the problem there is that they see our ad once. Right, they go to Google, search something, they see all these free results, they see our paid ads off to the side, and if they don't want to buy right then, they click on something else, then we've lost them forever. Now, Facebook makes a lot more sense because, like we said, people are on Facebook all the time. The other thing about Facebook is that we can almost read people's minds because everyone on Facebook has liked certain fan pages. So if someone on Facebook has liked, for example, Robert Allen, or they've liked Carlton Sheets, well, then we can target people who have already liked those fan pages, and we can say, well, you know, this person must really be into real estate, or maybe they've bought a real estate course in the past, and now we can talk to them every single day. Because they're always on Facebook, so even if our ad only gets shown once a day for 30 days and they eventually click, and then they, and we'll talk about in a little bit, either they can click over to our website from Facebook, or they can like our fan page, and then basically they're on our list, but we can wear them down over time. And it might take 10 days, 20 days, 30 days, but we can build this consistent list of people on this site called Facebook. And so, I mean, let's talk about that really quick, because we run these things called Facebook ads, and it can be just as simple as what I just told you. If you have a real estate course, then figure out, you know, what are the top 10 real estate personalities out there? And what are the top 10 real estate books? And what are the top 10 real estate courses? And then just advertise to all those things. You don't want to advertise for the term real estate, because who's even going to really put that in their profile? Right? So we want to figure out, you know, our perfect prospect, what exactly have they clicked the like button on? What have they voted on? And then we can advertise to this group of sometimes, you know, 500,000 people or sometimes millions of people. And then even if we want to narrow it down by location, by men and women, by a certain age group, like something like real estate, maybe you only want to target people who are 30 and up. Or 40 and up, and maybe people who live in the United States, right? And then we can really narrow it down and really talk to those people. So whether you have an opt-in page you want to send them to, a sales letter, you have a webinar coming up, you can send traffic off of Facebook to these external web pages, and you can do it very quickly and send a bunch of traffic at once. And if you even create this thing called a fan page, which means that you can say, real estate brokers, and then people can like that page, and then you can put out content and updates and information about real estate brokers. Or you can have your local pizza place, right? If you were going to set up a web presence for them, you could advertise to everyone in your town, and once again, a certain demographic. Do more like young people or old people like pizza, or men or women? And I know that everyone likes pizza, but do you have more of one group than anything else? Or can you go and create an ad and target people who have clicked the like button on the other pizza places around town, and then you run that ad and you build up your own fan base? And the best part about all this is you can click on one button and set this up where that it keeps advertising your fan page to them, but as soon as they click the like button, the ads stop. So you only pay, first of all, you can only pay for people who click, so you can be showing ads all day long, but you only pay when they click, and you only are running ads to people who have not yet liked your fan page. Lots of possibilities here, and you can join us over at setupafanpage.com to see all this in action. I mean, right now on this call, we can only talk about it because, you know, it's audio only, but in our Setup a Fan Page course, we show you how to create a fan page, how to add content to it, how to run ads, and Lance and I have set up quite a few fan pages, and I have a few open right now. He has one on the Boston Red Sox, the baseball team, and during the time we're recording this, it's got 59,000 likes. I set up a fan page about cats, and on that one, I promote Amazon products like automatic cat feeders, cat litter, magazines like Cat Fancy, little laser pointer cat toys. So that one has 15,000 likes. I have a country music page, which right now has, 25,000 likes. And on that one, I can promote things like, there's signed guitars I can link to on Amazon as an affiliate. There are signed autographs. There are songs, like you can buy digital downloads of like single songs, DVDs, like documentaries, CDs, so lots of possibilities. What it all comes down to, we're using Facebook for traffic, and even if we don't have a product of our own in this particular niche, we have so much traffic that we can send people to these affiliate links, to these Amazon web pages, and just take a commission of that and still make money without us having to do all this extra work, without having to spend 80% on creating the offer and 20% on the traffic. Instead, we spend 80% of our time and effort on the traffic, and then 20%, if that, on just locating the best offers and looking at what's selling and just promote more of that. So what's the process? Okay, well, on Facebook, creating a fan page is free, and it takes about 5 or 10 seconds, right? So in Facebook, you can go to like the fan pages area, and there's, I think, I hate saying this, but there's a green button, and chances are it'll change by the time you listen to this, but there's a button that says create a fan page. And they'll pretty much just ask you two questions. They'll ask what category is the fan page, and then what's the name of the fan page. And so, and there's pretty much just two options. I mean, they give you all these choices, like, do you want this, should this be like an entertainment thing or like a celebrity thing? And pretty much it comes down to, are you setting up a fan page where someone can like your brand, or are you setting up a fan page where someone can like a general interest? Like I just said, cats or country music is a general interest. That's called a community page. So you're setting up a Facebook fan page, and it's either a community page, which is like a general interest, or your personal brand, which might be like they have choices for like, you know, like a TV station or a local restaurant or like a service business, like an accountant, things like that. And let me just take a second to explain the three kinds of fan pages you would set up. I mean, the first one would be a brand page. So in my case, Lance and I have a company of our own called Double Agent Marketing, and we have set up a Facebook fan page for that company, so that people can basically subscribe to us on Facebook. Now, why would they do that? Because, well, yeah, we do send out emails, but email will only get you so far, and everyone's sending out emails. And if people are on Facebook all day long, I would rather send emails and promote on Facebook in addition. And I started thinking in this way when I started buying off Facebook. Now, what kind of stuff did I buy off Facebook? Things where someone might have been sending me emails about it, and I almost bought, but for some reason didn't quite buy. Maybe the timing wasn't right. Maybe I was busy right then. There was no time. Just whatever the reason was. But then if I saw another ad for that later on Facebook, whether it was an update on a fan page or something on an ad, then I ended up buying. And so the great thing is that when someone clicks the like button on your fan page, and then you post to that fan page's wall, then that update appears in their newsfeed. So if you post an interesting picture or video or link to your site or something like that, then that appears sandwiched in between all the other things that their friends are talking about. And if that person clicks the like button, not on the whole fan page, but on that post you made on that fan page, then that message that you had will then appear on their timeline, and then their friends will see it. If they click and leave a comment, same deal. So we have some of these posts on our fan pages that just grow and grow and grow. And I'm looking right now at a post that Lance made on his fan page about 24 hours prior to this. And he just posted the score of the Boston Red Sox, put in an Amazon affiliate link, and right now I'm looking at it, and it's just under 10,000 likes, so 9,969 likes, 2280 shares, so people have shared like on their own wall, and then I'm seeing 293,376 views. So, I mean, that's the size, that's a pretty good size city has seen his one blog post. And so that's the power of sites like this, like Facebook, is people are trained to click, like, and to share different posts. And so you, if you have something good to say, it'll just grow and grow and grow, as opposed to an email list, which is okay to have, but email takes a long time to send out. On Facebook, it's instant. With email, we experience about a 1% decay rate every single day with our emails, which means that, remember how we talked about having that list of 100,000 subscribers? Well, with that kind of a list, every single day, you're going to lose about 1,000 of your subscribers just because they'll unsubscribe on their own or the emails will go out of date. But either way, that list is 100,000 people. You might build that up on, say, January 1st. But on January 2nd, you're down to 99,000. On January 3rd, you're down to 98,000. And I mean, of course, that will slow down because it's still just 1% of the list that you have. But unless you're building that up, back up to replace people you've lost, then your business is shrinking. So there's no such thing as your business maintaining where it's at. It's either growing or it's dying. And so with Facebook fan pages, very few people actually unlike. I mean, when's the last time you really unliked a page? Maybe if they were posting all kinds of garbage over and over and over. But if they just updated once a day, you really don't unlike a fan page. And if anything, the fan page grows because as you like things or you share things, then your friends see that. And if they're interested, then they join the fan page as well. So, types of Facebook fan pages. You can have a page for your brand. I mean, I even have a fan page for this show, The Robert Plank Show, which you can go and like by going to robertsplankshow.com. Go to that page, click the like button, and I will mention your name on air, just like Robert Sterling, Milan Stefanik, Razu Sam Shamser, Yagub El Idi, Jaime Reyes, Graham Taylor, Patrice Filio, Richard Harley, and many more we'll get to in just a few minutes here. So, what are we talking about? Types of Facebook fan pages, brand pages. Well, so you can make a page about your company or your product. Like I can make a web page about Backup Creator, and then there's a place, and you make sure when you're doing that to make a page about your brand, not a general interest, not a community page, because when you make a page about your brand, they will allow you to, in fact, import your entire email list. So even if you only have a list of 1,000 people, or if you have a list of 100,000 people, there's a special area you can, like, I think it's build audience, where you can upload a text file containing an email address of every single person that's already on your email list. And then if they happen to have a Facebook account under that same email address, it will send them an email saying, click on the like button and like the page. What you can also do is, even if people don't immediately like that page, you can create what's called a custom audience. And inside Set Up a Fan Page, we show this exactly, but you can dump your whole email list and in a special area of Facebook, say, I want to advertise to this group of 50,000 people, all people who already know you, and then run an ad to them, inviting them to like your page. And yeah, you might have to pay a little bit. You might have to pay like a few cents for each person, maybe 20, 30, 50 cents. But they are building your fan base, and that's just one more way for you to contact them, and that will lead to more sales. And then what you can do with that brand page is then look at your competitors, your competing people, brands, products, companies, books, courses, and run ads to people who have already liked, remember, who've already voted that they are interested in those topics. And then, depending on the niche, you might actually pay something like $1 per like or 50 cents per like. And this is just the kind of thing where you want to run this for, just put it on a $10 a day budget. And the way that Facebook ads work is that if your ads convert very well, then they will bring down your ad cost. They will bring down what's called your cost per click, therefore your cost per like, because they want to reward you for creating relevant ads. Okay, so on Facebook, a 0.1% conversion rate, which means one of every 1,000 people who see that ad in the sidebar who click, that is good. And I've had some ads that are 1%, 2%, but the point is that if you can have an ad running at, if it's running at like 0.0 something percent, that's not good. Right, that cost is never going to drop, and you should pause those kinds of ads. But if you have an ad that's converting at 0.1%, 0.3%, 0.8%, that's very, very good on Facebook. And then the longer you run that, if you run that for about a week, you should see that ad cost going down. So you might start running ads at $1 per click, then it goes down to 50 cents, 30 cents, 20 cents, 10 cents, and then you can just consistently be building a list and talk to people who are interested in your brand. So you can create a web page or a fan page kind of like that, The second kind of fan page is a local page. So if you're a local business with an actual address, an actual office, a place people can come in, then these local fan pages are great because, I mean, let's say that you were a dentist office or you even wanted to approach a dentist office and help them out and get them some new business from Facebook. Well, you could, first of all, make it so that when someone types in their term dentist in Facebook and they're in your local town, then you will come up one of the first results. They can go to that page and instantly see the address, the hours you're open, the phone number, pictures of the inside, the outside, whatever updates you've made. So if you're a dentist office, you can post, maybe once a week, some tip about, you know, how to keep your teeth white or how to keep your gums healthy or how to reduce bad breath or how to make your dentist visits very easy, whatever that kind of thing is. You can create a local business kind of fan page where there are special places to add in your address. There's a map to your business. It's almost like having your own special website. And you can do all kinds of different fun, you know, promotions or rewards. It's like if you click the like button on this page, we'll give you a coupon for a free tooth whitening or however you want to run this. It's a lot of fun to create a local fan page, especially when most businesses are clueless about social media. They don't have anything set up. And so one time I went to my accountant a few years ago, and he had set up a page on Yelp.com. It's a place where you can review local businesses. And he said, can you go there and leave me your review telling people like how I am as an accountant? And I said, sure. I went home, looked him up on Yelp, and he hadn't filled anything in. And then Yelp said something like, well, this person hasn't filled anything in, but here's another accountant in the same town who has. So basically, people might have been looking for him on Yelp, but because he didn't actually fill anything in, Yelp sent me over to his competitor. And so it's a little devious that some of these sites do that, but all you have to do is put aside 10 minutes and fill it out, and then now you don't have to lose your business to other people. And there was like a pizza restaurant in town, and I went to look them up on Facebook, and they themselves had not filled anything in, but people were leaving bad reviews about this pizza restaurant. And it's a great place. Everything about this place is awesome, but a couple of people who were disgruntled said bad things, and if only they'd filled out a few things, added some pictures, and encouraged people who liked the restaurant to click the like button and leave good reviews to balance out these couple of complainers, they would have extra business without having to do very much. So we have a brand page, which is your company. You can have a local page, which is a local business in town where someone can come into. And then we have an umbrella page, which is most of the focus of our Set Up a Fan Page course. An umbrella page is a page where potentially it could be about like 50 different brands or people all combined. So if you made a page called I Love Dogs, I Love Poker, Wedding Advice, or Golfers, you could really build this up to hundreds of thousands or if not millions of people. So let's say you made a fan page about golf. Well, you could post a picture, post a video about golf every single day. And if someone is a golf enthusiast, a golf fanatic, a golf nut, well, then they are going to want to see all kinds of golf stuff, right? Not just golf tips, but pictures about golf, ideas about golf. For them, it's all golf all the time. And so if we ran ads to like Callaway golf clubs, if we ran ads to different country clubs where people played golf, if we ran ads for, I don't know if like Tiger Woods would be a good example, but other people who compete in like the PGA Tour who are not too mainstream, we could target 50 or 100 different brands and build up this huge fan page. And guess what? You can then drop in affiliate links to golf DVDs, golf courses, golf books, golf tees, golf equipment, golf clubs. And if you happen to be able to tie this into your own golfing business, even better. So let's say that you had, a sporting goods store or a golf store in town. You could set up a local page for your business and then an umbrella page and then post different promotions. And basically you have two groups of people, people who are in town and people who are in the rest of the world. And what's great about this is Facebook has this thing called EdgeRank, and they will reward interesting posts. So if you post to your Facebook fan page. If you post one update a day, and you don't want to post every hour, but just once a day, once a week is fine. If you post to that fan page once a day, as opposed to most people who only post once a year, once a month, then that's the first part of EdgeRank. Well, they will reward you for posting frequently, posting regularly. The next thing EdgeRank does is if someone is into golf, just to use that example, chances are they have a few friends that are into golf. And so if someone's friends all like your golf fan page, then that person who has all the golfing friends is more likely to see your updates. So another piece of EdgeRank is they will reward, they'll give your post more priority if their friends also like your fan page. And finally, the biggest one is likes and comments. So if I post to my golf fan page and you're one of my millions of fans of that page, and you just kind of read and look, but you never comment or like, well, Facebook's going to say you're only a casual observer. You're not a fanatic. But if you click the like button on every single post and picture and video and you comment on things, Facebook is going to give me a boost as far as what you see, because they will say, well, this person is very much into golf and we want to show more relevant content. So my point about all this is that even if you only have like a local kind of business, if you only have like a local accounting type of firm, well, if you have this umbrella page and you can get people to be like both your local page and your umbrella page, well, then you post an update and the rest of the world, people in, you know, Australia and Japan and Africa and Europe, they all click the like button. And you might post something like, I mean, I shared some numbers earlier, if you get 1,000 likes on a post, then those people in town, the ones you really want to talk to, are going to see your posts more often. Because by the way, just because you post on your fan page or you post on Facebook does not guarantee that people will see it, because Facebook is so crowded and they want to show just the most popular, just the most interesting posts. So I hope that cleared a lot of things up there about Facebook fan pages. You can make one about your brands and about your local business. And with those, I mean, if you have 1,000 likes, you're doing okay. If you have 10,000 likes, you're doing great. So those are some really hard-earned likes. Those might be some $1 per like, 50 cents per like. But then with the umbrella page, you can build this up to hundreds of thousands. Now with an umbrella page, I would say if you're getting 10,000 likes, you're doing okay. If you get 50,000 likes, you're doing great. And with these umbrella pages, because there's this huge audience you can market to, you should be able to get your cost down to 1 cent to 5 cents per like. So you can build up this huge, huge, massive audience and make money from people who buy from you directly. And even if they don't, then you can make money from affiliate links like from Amazon. And even if they don't buy, they will still help you because they will give you a boost in your EdgeRank. So back to the process of setting up a fan page. You create a fan page, you figure out what type of these pages that I'm creating, the name of it, and then you just post content daily. What I like to do with these umbrella pages, I go onto these called meme sites, M-E-M-E, go onto Google Images, and just look for, and even look up my competing fan pages, and look for interesting pictures to post, right? Like cute cat pictures, or in the country music one, pictures of different country music celebrities, or in the golf one, pictures of Tiger Woods, or whoever else is famous in the golf niche. I have a few students who have fan pages in the wine niche. So they post, pictures and reviews of different kinds of wine. There's the guitar niche. There is the gun niche. Like there's even some of these pages where they show you how to buy pieces of guns and get them and put them together. Like paintball, learning a language, just all these possibilities. So you grab these interesting images, you go to YouTube and get interesting videos, and then you can even schedule these ahead of time. And what I personally do is I like to grab about 30 of these and then just go in and schedule the whole month. It takes me about 30 minutes. And then I work in my affiliate links, and we show you this and set up a fan page so that it all just builds on its own because of the ads. And then it puts offers in front of them on a timer because of these scheduled posts. So we have the page going, we have the content scheduled to go, and then we run these advertisements, right? And like I keep saying a bunch of times, we target your competing competing fan pages, like people who have other golf pages, and the brands, like celebrities or like equipment or products in your niche. And some will pay off and some won't. And instead of a fan page, we have like a, I think like a 5-point criteria for the kinds of fan pages that will work out and which ones won't. And then we run these ads until, and we run them for a few days because, like we said, Facebook rewards you for high converting ads for 0.1% or higher. So you have to let these run for about a week to prove that you convert very well. And if you convert above 0.1%, then the cost will drop and drop and drop and drop. And if you can drop below 10 cents per click and per like, then you're doing great. And then you should, now you know that's a winning niche and it will just grow on its own every day for 10 bucks a day. So if you get lucky, you can actually get 1 cent likes. And what that means is that if you get a like for 1 cent and your ad budget is 10 bucks a day, then every day you're increasing your likes by 1,000 fans. So you have 1,000 fans, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, and it just grows and grows and grows until you can get enough traffic back to Amazon to or back to whatever link you're promoting to make it all worthwhile. And so this means that if you're selling like golf training or you're selling real estate training, then when it comes time for you to run a webinar or run a promotion on one of your products, yeah, you can run ads and you should run ads directly to the URL. But then if you've trained this Facebook fan page, the people to click like and to even buy affiliate products, then if you drop the link to your own products in this fan page, those are all free clicks. That's all free traffic. That's all free extra sales that you can claim right now. So inside of Set Up a Fan Page, we show you all these advanced strategies like how we split test our ads, or how I can run an ad to just one person. I can narrow it down really targeted, and if I want to talk to just one person, I can put in their name and their picture in the ad, and I can do all kinds of fancy stuff like stop advertising a certain product to someone if they've bought. Lots and lots of advanced strategies, but they're all easy to implement, and it's a lot better than, and I don't want to trash talk any competitors, but a lot of people who sell Facebook training, they teach you how to make like an iframe tab, or how to make this thing called a like gate, or pay for fake likes, or invite your friends to your fan page, or send them off to an opt-in page. All these things that simply don't work. Facebook is just one other traffic source that you should be using. So when you email to your list, you should also be promoting on Facebook in addition, because you'll have some overlap. You have some people who are on your list who end up just not buying right away, but because you follow up with them in this other channel that they're not used to, well, then you can make extra clicks, traffic, opt-ins, and sales from Facebook. And it just comes down to list traffic and offers. What it always comes down to, list traffic and offers. So offers could be your product or could be affiliate links, but either way, you have things for sale that people can buy, and you want to find targeted prospects, targeted leads who are interested in that, and you just send them over to them. Now, how do you do that? Well, you have a list. Now, it's good to have an email list, but a Facebook fan page and your fan base on that Facebook site, that's also a list. So if you have 100,000 fans, then that's just as good as 100,000 email subscribers, because they're always on this site and they share with their friends, and some of these links can go viral to hundreds of thousands of people if you do it right. And then the middle part we talked about is traffic. Well, Facebook is the most social site at the time that we're recording this, and there's people on there all the time, and so you wouldn't be very smart if you ignored Facebook for very much long. You need to do it. You need to start running Facebook ads. You need to set up a Facebook fan page and then adjust and see which ads are converting well, which offers are converting well, and use it to make more money. So I hope that helped, and I hope that kind of opened your eyes and got you started with Facebook fan pages. At first, I didn't get it either. At first, I thought, isn't everyone on here to socialize? Isn't there, why are people even buy things. Why would everyone want to pay me money on Facebook? Well, because everyone's on there and you can target the biggest fans of golf, real estate, guitars, wine, whatever niche you are promoting in. And so I hope that everyone listening at least has a Facebook fan page set up, at least is running a Facebook ad. And you know what? I'm talking to you, Ron Roach, Peter Moog, Paul Reed, Alana Anderson, Gerhard Achleitner, Peter Sauer, Mike Witter, Michael Dodden, Richard Wright, Jim Allen III, Dwayne Villiers, Mas Kadiri, Namor Mila, Ladit Vizirani, and John Scott. Those are all people who have liked The Robert Plank Show by going to robertplankshow.com. So click the like button, and I can't guarantee that I'll mention you like the very next episode because we have quite a huge list, quite a backlog of people who've liked the page. But go there, go to robertplankshow.com, click the like button, and I'll see you inside the members area of setupafanpage.com, which is an entire home study course where we show you all of our video training on how to get this page set up, how to choose the niche right, how to get the ads going, how to make them profitable, how to make money, how to promote the affiliate links. It's all in there. It's all in one place for you inside of setupafanpage.com. So I'm Robert Plank. This has been The Robert Plank Show. And I want you to like the Facebook fan page, subscribe to us on iTunes, and join us for next episode, which is episode 18, how to set up your very own income machine, including a blog, opt-in page, follow-up sequence, sales letter, membership site, traffic, and more that makes you money while you sleep. So,